let us explain about the cell organelles, that is endoplasmic reticulum. So endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, right. So first we know the history of the endoplasmic reticulum. Yeah, first we know the introduction. Right. So endoplasmic reticulum was first obtained by observed by the scientist called Gardner. Okay. So firstly, endoplasmic reticulum was observed. So observed by Gardner. Okay. Okay, so Gardner. And the term endoplasmic reticulum was coined by the term endoplasmic reticulum is coined by Porter. Okay, but the ultrastructure of the endoplasmic reticulum, ultrastructure generally of endoplasmic reticulum of ER is described by three scientists. They are Porter, Clarks, and Fullens. These three scientists describe the structure, ultrastructure of the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, right. So this is the introduction or history of the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so right. Now we know the definition of the endoplasmic reticulum. So what is endoplasmic reticulum generally? So generally, the endoplasmic reticulum is a complex, finely divided vascular system. Okay. It is a complex and finely divided vascular system. Okay, so vascular system that extending through cytoplasm to the plasma membrane of cell. Okay, right. So this forms a network-like structure. This extends throughout the cytoplasm. Okay, and it forms a network-like structure. Okay, it is one of the framework to the cell. Okay. Yes, it gives the mechanical support to the cell. So this is about the definition. So definition means endoplasmic reticulum is a complex, finely divided vascular system. Okay, extending through cytoplasm to the plasma membrane of the cell. Okay, right. So this is the nucleus and this is the cytoplasm. So endoplasmic reticulum extends. Through the cytoplasm and up to plasma membrane. Okay, like this, right. So now we know the occurrence of the endoplasmic reticulum. So occurrence. So where it is the presence. Okay, occurrence means presence. Okay, so where it is present. So endoplasmic reticulum is present in all eukaryotic cells. Present in all eukaryotic cells. Germinal cells. So germinal cells and matured mammalian RBC. Okay, so matured mammalian RBC does not contain any cell organelles. After matured of RBC, it does not contain any cell organelles. Okay, so except these two, all eukaryotic cells contains endoplasmic reticulum.
handle. The endoplasmic reticulum is absent in prokaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cells. Okay, right. So this is the presence. Okay, right. So the what is the number of endoplasmic reticulum? So generally, the number of endoplasmic reticulum is depends on the metabolic rate. Okay, metabolic rate. Those cells need more proteins and lipids. Then the number of endoplasmic reticulum is also more. Okay, if does not need proteins that much, then the endoplasmic reticulum number is also lower. Okay, right. So that depends. The number is depends on the metabolic rate. Okay, right. So this is about the occurrence. Okay, right. Now we know the morphology of endoplasmic reticulum. Elements of the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, right. So elements or morphology. Okay. So elements of endoplasmic reticulum. Elements or morphology. Okay, right. So generally, it occurs in three morphological forms. It occurs in three elements. Okay, right. It occurs in three elements. Okay, right. So what is that? They are found in three elements. So one is cisternae. So cisternae. Okay, one is cisternae. And the second one is vesicles. So vesicles, and third one is tubules. Okay, so tubules. Okay, right. So they look like cisternae, vesicles, and tubules. Now, first we know about the cisternae. First we take about the cisternae. Yeah. So what is cisternae? So generally, so. First we explain about the cisternae. Okay, right. So these are the narrow tubular structures. Okay, here we see for example the diagram is this is the taking. So this is the nucleus. Okay, nuclear membrane, and this nuclear membrane like this. Okay, right. So generally, cisternae are the narrow tubular-like structures. Okay, so they have a narrow diameter of 40 to 50 angstroms. Okay, so 40 to 50 micrometers. Okay, right. So, but first we know the formation of the cisternae. So generally, the cisternae are formed by the evagination of nuclear membrane. Okay, by the evagination of nuclear membrane. Then the cisternae are formed by the nuclear membrane. Evagination of nuclear membrane. That means, yes, we see this is the nuclear membrane. So this is the nuclear membrane. Okay, nuclear membrane. Here we see the nuclear membrane becomes a invaginate. Here we see the nuclear membrane is showing the invaginate. Okay, so in the invaginate. Invaginate means outer fold. Okay, outer fold. That is the evagination. Invagination means inner fold. That is the invagination. And here you see the evagination. Okay, right. So after the evagination, one cisternae will be formed. This is the cisternae. Okay, a narrow tubular like structure. Okay, and this one forms the another cisternae. Okay, like this, another cisternae, and this one also forms the another cisternae. Like these cisternae are the interconnected one of the other. Okay, so these are the cisternae. So these are the narrow tubular-like structures. Okay, and the diameter or lumen diameter is about 40 to 50. So 40 to 50 micrometers. Okay, so diameter of lumen. Okay. So diameter of lumen is, that means lumen means this is the gap. Okay, lumen, the cavity. Okay, it is about 40 to 50 micrometers. Okay, right. So here some ribosomes are present on the cisternase. Okay, you see the this is the ribosomes. These are the ribosomes. Okay, so these are the ribosomes. So some ribosomes are present on the outer surface. Okay, outer surface on the membrane. Okay, right. So these ribosomes generally attached by a glycoprotein. So these ribosomes. So these are the ribosomes. Okay, these are the ribosomes, and this is one is the cisternae. Okay, cisternae. Okay, right. So ribosomes are attached on the outer membrane of the cisternae. Okay, but these ribosomes are attached by a glycoprotein. Attached by a glycoprotein called riboporin. Okay, riboporin. Okay, riboporin is a protein which attached the ribosomes on the membrane of cisternae. Okay, right. So this is about the cisternae. Okay, so cisternae are very close to the nuclear membrane. Okay, very close to the nuclear membrane. Okay, right. So this is about the cisternae. Now we know about the second element part is vesicles. Yeah, so vesicles. Here we see the vesicles. Okay, so these are the vesicles. So these are the like this. These are the vesicles. Oval or irregular in shape. Okay, oval or irregular in shape. These are called as vesicles. Okay, these are the vesicles. Okay, right. So these vesicles, the lumen of these vesicles diameter is about 50 to 500 micrometers. Okay, the lumen diameter, diameter is of 50 to 500 micrometers. Okay, right. So these vesicles are very close to the cisternae. Very close to the. Here we see the diagram. So these are the cisternae. These are the cisternae which are evasionate from the nuclear membrane. And these are the cisternae. These are the vesicles. These are the vesicles. Okay. These are the vesicles. Okay. And this one is the cisternae. Cisternae. Okay. These are the cisternae. Okay, these are the vesicles. So vesicles are very close to the cisternae. Okay, right. Okay, so this is about. But here the ribosomes are absent on the surface. There is no ribosomes. Okay, right. And the third element is tubules. Okay, third element is tubules. So you see the tubules. For example, one of the diagram. Yeah, these are the tubules. Okay, these are the tubules. Okay, so these are also tubular-like structures. Okay, and they form a network, and they form a network. Okay, right. So these tubules, the diameter, the lumen diameter of these tubules are 50 to 100 micrometers. Okay, the diameter. So diameter of lumen is 50 to 100 micrometers. Okay, here we see these are the generally tubules. Okay. These are the tubules. Okay, they form a network. Okay, right. So these are very close to the plasma membrane. These are very close to the plasma membrane. Okay, so tubules are very close to the plasma membrane. Okay, this is about the these three elements of endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, now we know the types of the endoplasmic reticulum. So types of endoplasmic reticulum. So what are the types which are included in? Okay, right. So there are, I think already you know that. So generally based on the ribosomes presence or absence, based on the presence or absence of ribosomes, generally endoplasmic reticulum is classified into two types. Okay, so one is rough endoplasmic reticulum. One is rough endoplasmic reticulum. And the second one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so based on the presence or absence of ribosomes. Okay, right. So first we know about the rough endoplasmic reticulum. okay, right? So of ER, okay, ER means denoted endoplasmic reticulum, okay, right? So rough ER means this type of endoplasmic reticulum generally contains rough walls because of ribosomes are present on the outer surface. Okay, so they contains rough walls because they contains the ribosomes on the outer surface. Okay, right. So presence of ribosomes. Okay, presence of ribosomes on the outer surface. That's why they are in rough on surface. Okay, right. So this rough endoplasmic reticulum also called as missiles. Okay, so missiles. Missiles body or ergastoplasm. Okay, also called as, they have different names. So missile bodies and ergastoplasm. Okay, right. So here we see this diagram. So these are the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So these are the rough endoplasmic reticulum. So these are the rough ER. So rough endoplasm, they have ribosomes on its outer surface. Okay, right. And the rough, generally the endoplasm, generally the ribosomes function. What is the ribosome function? Generally, commonly ribosomes are produce proteins. Okay, they are responsible in protein synthesis. So that ribosomes are present on the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, that's why the endoplasmic reticulum is rough endoplasmic reticulum is also active in protein synthesis. Okay, right. So the function is protein synthesis. Okay, so protein synthesis. Okay, protein synthesis. Okay, right. So already you know that the ribosomes generally attached on the surface by a ribophorin protein. Okay, so this is about the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so rough endoplasmic reticulum mostly present in the present. So more rough ER is present in the pancreatic cells. So pancreatic cells. Okay, and endocrine glands. Okay, endocrine glands. Okay, and some of these type of cells, generally rough endoplasmic reticulum is more in number. Okay, because here the protein synthesis will be occur. Okay, the more protein synthesis will be occur. So where the protein synthesis is more, there the rough endoplasmic reticulum is more in number. Okay, like this. Now the second one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, right. So smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Here there is ribosomes are absence. Okay, absence of ribosomes. Okay, yeah, absence of ribosomes. The outer surface is smooth. Here we see this is the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. There is no ribosomes on its surface. Okay, right. So here smooth endoplasmic reticulum generally responsible in lipid synthesis. Okay, lipid synthesis. They have responsible in metabolism of carbohydrates and lipids. Okay, carbohydrates and metabolism of carbohydrates and lipids. Okay, so these are mostly present in adipocytes. Mostly present in adipocytes where the fats are formed and stored. Okay, so lipids are formed and stored. So adipocytes and liver cells. Okay, where the glycogenolysis process will be occurred. Glycogenolysis, that means breakdown of glycogen. That will be occurred in the liver cell. So that in that also they are more in number. Okay, like this. And leading cells. Okay, so leading cells. That means leading cells produce testosterone. okay, hormone. Testosterone is a steroid hormone, lipid steroid hormone. Okay, that's why in these cells also smooth endoplasmic is more in number. Okay, like these some cells have more in number, those who are produced steroids, lipids. Okay, right. So this is about the types of endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, another video we discuss about the functions.